Hello and welcome, it's Chris here. About 2 months ago, my friend Stuart Lynch showed you how to build a Mac OS taskbar app. Now, in the next three lessons of this series, Stuart will show you how to turn that app into an iOS app, an iOS widget, and a watch OS app. Now, this is part two of that series. If you enjoy this video, I highly recommend that you check out Stuart's own YouTube channel as well. All right, let's dive in.
Hi, my name's Stuart Lynch. And in this video, you'll learn how to extend the Dad Jokes application that we prepared in the video on creating a Menubar app to offer an iPhone and iPad version. We'll start by adding a copy button to the Mac app so that you can share those jokes with others. Then we'll create an iOS target so we can run the app on an iPhone or an iPad. We'll learn about target membership so that we don't have to write a lot of redundant code and share it between targets. And we'll use compiler conditionals to adjust the code based on the operating system in use. We'll also ensure that our app runs and looks great on both an iPhone and an iPad. I highly recommend that you watch the previous video in this series, as this one builds on that one and depends on it. If you completed that Mac version, you can continue on from there, or you can use the completed version of that first video that you can download from the link in the description. So before we move on to adding that iPhone app, let's add that Menubar app's copy button. I want to add a copy button to the Menubar view so that we can copy that great joke and perhaps paste it into a text or an email to someone. This is really quite easy to do. Within the joke view, we'll add that copy button after we display the joke string. So within the else block, embed the joke string in a V stack and follow that with an H stack. Start with a spacer, and this is going to push a button to the right. And that button will be one that contains a text view for the label, and we'll just use the word copy. And since I added the button in, let's change that preview height to 255. For the action, we'll first create a pasteboard property, and that's an nspasteboard.general property. Next, we'll clear its contents using pasteboard clear contents. Then we can set the string of the pasteboard to the joke string for type nspasteboard.pasteboardtype.string. We've added more height to our little menu now, so though it's still longer, you still see it here in the preview. We'll want to increase the length so that our text string does not get minimized beyond readability for those longer jokes. So we'll return to the application menu file and increase the height there to the frame height of 255. We can test this out now by building and running. When I tap on that Dad Jokes icon in the menu bar now, I see that my joke appears with that copy button below it. I can tap on that button, and then if I bring up a text editor, I can paste into it and see that the joke that was presented in the app gets pasted into the page. Great. Well, before we move on, I've been using source control for this project, so let's commit our changes to Git. Now I'm going to start this new iOS app now. So I want to create a new branch. And in Xcode 13, we have a faster way now to create new branches from the current branch. We can do it directly now from the source code item here. So let's do that, and we'll call the branch iOS app. And we'll create that branch. So now on to the main part of this lesson. We want to create an iPhone app, but we also wanted to utilize a lot of the code that we already created in that first video, because much of it will be definitely reusable. So let's organize our files first before we do that. There are four files that we can use: the API service class, our joke model, the joke type enum, And we'll even be able to reuse this joke view, as we want to have the basic same display on the iPhone. We'll just change some sizes, but more about that in a minute. So to organize our content better, let's create a new folder called Shared. And I'm going to move it outside of our dad joke folder or target and onto its own above. And I'm going to now move all four of those files into that folder. Now our iPhone app is going to be an independent application, so we'll need a new target for this. From the file menu, choose New Target. And make sure you click on the iOS tab and search for and select App. Name that target Dad Jokes iOS, and then click on Finish. And this creates a new folder grouping with a new app entry point and a new content view and assets folder for this target. Now, each target has its own entry point, and that's the file marked with app main. What I like to do is to first rename the entry point for our Mac app as macentry.swift. Don't change the struct name, just the file name in the navigator. After you do that, you can rename the start page for the iOS app as iOS entry. Now let's return to that shared folder and reveal the file inspector. And what we want to do is to assign the Dad Jokes iOS as an additional target membership for those four files. This means that these files are going to be accessible to our new target. Now, I've provided some new assets for this target, so open the Assets folder for the target and delete the App Icon folder and replace it with the one that's provided. Copy also the Launch Screen asset into it. Now, create a new file and search for Launch Screen and add it to the iOS target. Delete the text label that's there and replace it with an image that is that launch screen that we uploaded. Set the constraints so that it's horizontally and vertically adjusted to the center of the screen. Now I want to use this launch screen storyboard as the launch screen for my app. So we'll select the Dad Jokes iOS target and set the launch screen file to this new launch screen. Now I want all of my app targets to have the same display name, which is Dad Jokes. So for the display name, we'll just add Dad Jokes instead. Next, we want to restrict the rotation on an iPhone to always be portrait. We'll allow the iPad to go both ways, but the iPhone portrait only. So on the Info tab, in the supported interface orientations for iPhone, remove both of the landscape versions. The shared joke view displays the Stuart Lynch icon that is currently used on the Mac app. It's a 1x image only, so I want to fix that up by adding a 2x and a 3x image. And I'll also be able to use this in my iPhone app. So I'm going to replace the image by all three of those provided. Back in the shared folder, I'm going to create a new asset catalog. I'll call it Shared Assets. And then I'm going to cut the Stuart Lynch image out of the Mac only target and paste it here into this shared one. And now make sure that you also set the target membership of this entire catalog to be both of our targets now, so that this image will be available to both. Now, it may very well be that our new image is not square. So let's open that joke view for now. Remember, it's still being used by the Mac app and shortly will be for the iOS app. And I'm going to set an aspect ratio where the content mode is fit. And then I'm going to remove the height in the frame and just leave it as a width of 60. So everything is now still good for the Mac menu bar app. Well, I'm going to change the scheme now to a dad joke iOS, and I'm going to pick a device like an iPhone 13 Pro. So essentially now we're working on the iPhone app. Now I'm going to run into some problems. And the biggest one is that this view uses the NS pasteboard, and that's a Mac OS option only. You get this error that you can't find NS pasteboard because it's not available to iOS. On iOS, it's called the UI pasteboard. So we'll need to use a compiler conditional directive to check what the OS is. And we can do that by surrounding this action with a pound if, or hashtag if, depending on how you want to pronounce that, OS being Mac OS, and then another hashtag end if. So now this will only be displayed if we're on a Mac. Well, there is an equivalent of the NS pasteboard for the iPhone. As I said, it's UI pasteboard. So we can add a hashtag else. And then the corresponding pasteboard for iOS is UI pasteboard. And we can add to that pasteboard just by assigning our joke string to the pasteboard's string property. And if we reset the preview now, we see the iPhone 13 Pro is displayed. Well, we want to incorporate this joke view into our view, the current content view, which is our iOS target, just like we did when we embedded it in the application menu in our Mac app. But let's fix some other things up first. To make the button stand out a bit more, we can set the button style on the VStack to a bordered button style. This won't affect the Mac version at all. It's basically ignored by the Mac. And it turns out here that the frame size I set here is actually redundant, so I can remove it. But because I have a preview frame set to 255, the joke string is compressed. Well, we can fix that in the preview by adding another OS conditional in the preview this time. And present the view with no frame if the OS is iOS. Else, we'll use the other one for the macOS that does set the frame. That's looking better. There's some more things that I want to fix up though for this iOS version. I want to have a larger image, and I want to present that joke with larger text as there's more room. And the easy one to do is to fix that copy button so that it's bordered. So fix that copy button by adding a bordered style. To adjust the width, I'll create a computed property at the top of the struct, and I'm going to call it image width of type CG float. And I'll do another OS conditional check so that if the OS is Mac OS, we'll return a width of 60, else we'll return 120. And then we can replace the frame width with image width. I also want to increase the font size if we're on the iPhone or iPad. So I'm going to create a similar computed property, but call it font, that is of type font, and I'll return body if it's Mac OS, and then else we must be on iOS, I'm going to return title. And then we can add a font property to where we display our joke string just before the minimum scale factor. This is looking pretty good now. We can now finally update the view that is presented when we present our iOS version, and that's the content view. Let's rename that to iOS JokeView, making sure that you also select the comment to be renamed, and afterwards change that preview provider name as well. Remove that text view and replace it with a navigation view that will display our shared joke view. Add a navigation title of Dad Jokes. And since we're allowing this to be displayed on an iPhone and an iPad, because we have a navigation view, I want to remove that splitting that happens on an iPad navigation. So I'm going to add a navigation style of stack. Let's test this now in the simulator. We see that it functions basically the same way as the menu bar app now, but the text is much larger on the iPhone. And I have a copy button here, so let's copy this joke. Now, if I go to an app where I can paste in the text, I'll be able to verify that. So let me open this fake messages app here on the simulator. And I'm going to paste in that joke to a message to this KB character here, whoever that is. Great. That works. Let's also test out on an iPad. If we choose, for example, the iPad Air and run, I see that I can rotate my screen and it all just works. However, I don't really like this when the joke expands to the entire width. I'd rather keep it a little bit more confined. So let's try and fix that. Back in the joke view, I want to set the width of the screen to be a maximum of the device width minus 24 padding, which will handle the iPhone because the width isn't going to change because the rotation is restricted. But on the iPad, I want to limit that to a maximum of 600. I don't want to do anything if it's on the macOS. I just want to leave it alone. So I'm going to create one more computed property in JokeView that I'll call FrameWidth, which is a CG float. And I'm going to conditionally return different values based on the OS. So if the OS is macOS, I'll return 205, which we had before. And that'll give us some padding to our copy button. Else, I'll return the minimum of the UI screen dot main dot bounds dot size dot width minus 20 for padding, and that's going to handle the iPhone, and 600 for both orientations of my iPad. And then finally, then I can set the frame on that entire V stack to be the frame where the width is our new computed frame width. Let's test once more on all three devices now. First, the iPad. Looks great in both orientations. Let's bring up the iPhone. Yes, still looks good. And finally, just to make sure that we've not broken anything on the Mac app, we need to test this out too. And it looks great as well. So make sure you commit your changes, because in the next video in this series, we'll create a new branch and add a widget to our iOS version so that we can see a random joke presented to us on our iPhone or iPad home screen at regular intervals throughout the day. Thanks for watching.